यशोदानंदन व्रज जनरंजन यशोदानंदन व्रज जनरंजन जय जय राधा माधव जय हो कुंज बिहार जय हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे राधे हो जय जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय श्री गोपाल श्री गोपाल जय श्री गोपाल जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय प्रभुपाद जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रवजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्रीमधीर डिवाइन ग्रेस ऐसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्रजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शत श्रीमधीर डिवाइन ग्रेस भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय नामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। गंगा मैया जमुना मैया की जय। भक्ति देवी श्री तुलसी महारानी की जय। निताई गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल हरि हरि बोल। निताई गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल। ओ नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीरुत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। तप्तका राधे वृंदावनेश्वरे वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। वांछा कल्पतरु कृपा सिंधु पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Shri Shri Balaram Jayanti Mahamahotsav Ki Jai. Hare Krishna. Today we are celebrating the most auspicious occasion of Balaram's appearance day. So we have selected one verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10th, Chapter 2 and Text Number 8. देवक्या जठरे गर्भं शेषाख्यं धाममामकं तत्सन्निकृष्ण रोहिण्या उदरे सन्निवेशय. देवक्या जठरे गर्भं शेषाख्यं धाममामकं तत्सन्निकृष्य रोहिशा रोहिण्या उदरे सन्निवेशय. देवक्या जठरे गर्भं शेषाख्यं धाममामकं तत्सन्निकृष्य रोहिण्या उदरे सन्निवेशय. Translation performed by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada. Translation: within the womb of Devaki is my partial plenary expansion known as Sankarshan or Shesha. Without difficulty, transfer him into the womb of Rohini. Purport: the first plenary expansion of Krishna is Baladev, also known as Shesha. The Shesha incarnation of the Supreme Lord supports the entire universe, and the eternal mother of this incarnation is Mother Rohini. Because I am going into the womb of Devaki, the Lord told Yogamaya, the Shesha incarnation has already gone there and made suitable arrangements so that I may live there. Now he should enter the womb of Rohini, his eternal mother. In this connection, one may ask how the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is always situated transcendentally, could enter the womb of Devaki, which had previously been entered by the six asuras, the six garbhas. Does this mean that the shad garbhasuras, six asuras, the shad gandharvas, does this mean that Supreme Personality of Godhead, So Vishnu Chakra Thakur writes, the entire creation as well as its individual parts is an expansion of the energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, even though the Lord enters the material world, he does not do so. This is explained by the Lord himself in Bhagavad Gita. Om Jnanati Mandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmildam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamite Namane Namaste Saraswati Deva Bhauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschata Deshita Hare Krishna.
So once in Allahabad, during Kumbh Mela, Srila Prabhupada and all his associates, disciples, they went to attend Kumbh Mela, and suddenly a dispute took place between Madhudisha Prabhu and Mother Jamuna, Yamuna Mataji. So Madhudisha Prabhu was saying that there is absolutely no difference between Krishna and Balaram, except Krishna wears peacock feather and Balaram does not. And then Yamuna Mataji said that, yes, there is one more difference. Krishna is the only enjoyer of Sri Radha. So there was argument going on between these two. So finally, Tamala Krishna Goswami Maharaj, who was secretary of Srila Prabhupada, he took the matter to in front of Srila Prabhupada, and he said, Prabhupada, Madhudisha Prabhu says that there is no difference between Krishna and Balaram except the peacock feather. And Yamuna Mai C says this. So Prabhupada said, Madhudisha is right. Then Tamala Krishna Maharaj said, what about Mother Yamuna? Prabhupada says, she is also right. So then Tamala Krishna Maharaj said, Prabhupada, how is that possible? How could both of them be true? Right? Then Prabhupada said, you are also right. Because in Krishna consciousness, nothing is limited. Everything is right, everyone is right. So then, but after some time later on, this matter was resolved. When Prabhupada was in Krishna Balaram temple, he was taking darshan of Krishna Balaram, so beautiful. And then Prabhupada, he was surrounded by all his devotees. So Prabhupada asked them, asked all of them, who is stronger among these two, Krishna or Balaram? Who is stronger? So most of the devotees said, Prabhupada, Balaram is stronger than Krishna. Because Bala means strength. Because Balaramji was very famous for his strength. Balaramji would not play around with the demons. He would, with one punch, he would kill all the demons. Dhenukasur, with one punch, he killed him. With one punch, he killed Pralambasur. Because Balaramji said, my brother Krishna, he has a mood of performing Leela. I don't have a time. I have to my time is so precious. I have to serve Krishna. So therefore, I don't play around with these demons. With one punch, I kill all the demons. So he was very famous for his bala. So, and Prabhupada was very much fond of listening Krishna Balaram's Leela, fighting and killing with the demons. So one instance in Vrindavan, one devotee was reading the pastimes of how Balaramji, he killed Dvivida, the gorilla demon. And then he started reading that gorilla, he was so mischievous personality. He was passing urine and stool in the yajnas of the rishis. And then Balaramji, with one blow, he killed that demon. And Prabhupada went in ecstasy. And Prabhupada slapped his thighs. I said, wow! So because Prabhupada liked his, hearing Krishna and Balaram killing demons. So the next day, the devotee again, he was looking for some chapter where Krishna and Balaram is killing some demons. And then Krishna, Prabhupada looked at the devotee and said, don't worry. Start reading from anywhere. Because Krishna is like a sweet ball. He's like a rasagulla. He's like a sweet ball. You can start eating from any side. Rasagulla doesn't matter, whether it's a left corner is a sweet or a right corner is a sweet. Rasagulla is sweet everywhere. So similarly, Prabhupada said, Krishna's pastimes are everywhere. Krishna's pastimes are very sweet. Krishna and Balaram, they are the source of happiness for everyone. In Vrindavan Dham, Krishna and Balaram and all his Govard boyfriends, every day they go for a picnic. our jobs, like, you know, Saturday, Sunday, everyone becomes so happy that, wow, today is Saturday. Saturday night, tomorrow morning is Sunday, so I can sleep for a long time. Because Monday onwards, again, I have to go for a job and business. So sometimes our job, because this is all a ugra karma, Krishna is not involved in our services. Therefore, these office jobs and businesses, they look like austerity. But of course, those who are devotees of Krishna, those who are chanting Hare Krishna, their office work, their business is also service to Krishna. But originally, we are all actually meant to participate in Krishna's Leela. So Krishna and Balaram, all the cowherd boys, actually cowherd boys, somehow that they would spend their night, the austerity, the night, spending night, it was like a torturous for them. They would just wait when the morning the sun will rise and will again join with Krishna and Balaram, going to the pasturing grounds and playing different games on the banks of river Jamuna. And what is Krishna's games? Prabhupada says, where did this racing mentality came? Where did this racing mentality come in the human society? We see car racing, we see horse racing. Then Prabhupada said, because in Vrindavan, Krishna, Balaram and all the cowherd boys, they race with the birds. They race with the deers. So Krishna has those inclinations, those propensities to enjoy different games. So therefore all the human society, all the human beings, they also have same propensity and inclination what Krishna enjoys in the Vrindavan pasturing grounds. Our Krishna is so personal, amazing. Krishna takes all his devotees, Balaram and all the cows, to Vrindavan pasturing grounds. And Krishna has 900,000 of cows, 9 lakh cows, and he has a name for each and every cow. Some cows are called Lali, Pita, Hamsi, Mridangamukhi. See the difference. Apart from Vedic culture, if you see those who don't follow Vedic culture, in their religion or worship of God, they don't even have name for God. What to speak of, you know, here in the Krishna consciousness, Krishna has names for each and every cow. What to speak of his friends and his relatives and his parents? Huh? And other religions, even God doesn't have name. Here, Krishna has, each and every cow has a name. So this shows Krishna is so personal. It's all depend on actually our inclination. If you want to serve Krishna, if you have the desire to serve him with love and devotion, Krishna will provide that facility. Krishna will give. Krishna will somehow then make arrangement that inclination, that desire to serve him is arise in our heart. But actually we are lacking. So Krishna, so that point, Balaramji is strong or Krishna is strong. So everyone was saying that Prabhupada, Balaramji is strong, because even in Mahabharata also, there is a description during this incognito, when the Pandavas were in incognito in Virat kingdom, last 13th year, Bhima killed Kichak. So immediately Duryodhana and everyone got the clue that the Pandavas are in Virat. Because Karna says, only 6 personality has a power and strength to kill Kichak. And out of these 6, Karna says, Balaram. He mentions Balaram's name. And he says, Bhima. So Balaram did not kill, and other 4, they also didn't kill. So Pandavas must be in Virat kingdom. Actually, Balaramji was very famous for his strength. Balaram's style was killing the soldiers on the battlefield. He would hit on the ground, on the earth, with his plow. And earth would shake in fears. There was an earthquake whenever he would hit his plow on the earth. And on the battlefield, there were the big giant's cracks. And earth, Mother Bhumi, she would swallow all the soldiers live. So Balaramji would give live samadhis to all the soldiers. Because his style was, I don't want to waste my time, you know. So whenever he was there in the fight, somehow they, within just short period of time, he would just kill everyone. All the big, big armies, Akshayani, Sainis, you know, within short time. And therefore, Jarasandh was afraid of Balaram. He was not afraid of Krishna. Somehow other Balaramji, Jarasandh was not afraid of Krishna. He was afraid of Balaramji. So when Samba was kidnapped by the Kauravas, because Samba had kidnapped Lakshmana, daughter of Duryodhan, so they all the warriors of Kauravas came together, defeated Samba and kidnapped him. So then Balaramji, he told all the Yadavas, don't worry, I will go and settle the matter. So Balaramji went, and Balaramji very humbly he started speaking to the Kauravas. But Kauravas, instead of respecting Balaram, they started offending him. And then Balaram went in his transcendental anger, ecstasy. He took out his plow and started dragging the whole Hastinapur city into the Mother Ganges. And then they understood, oh my God, Balaramji, please forgive us, please forgive us. So Balaramji, he was very, very strong. Then Prabhupada was taking darshan. Prabhupada listened all the arguments of all the devotees. And then Prabhupada said, but Krishna is more stronger than Balaram. And then what is the proof? Is there anything in the Shastras mentioned? Prabhupada said, no. Look how Balaramji is resting on the shoulder of Krishna. If he was strong, why is he resting his hands, is on the shoulder of Balaram, on the shoulder of Krishna? That shows Krishna is more stronger. So this is, devotee's logic. There is no need of any quotation of the Shastra. This is Prabhupada's ecstasy. So Shastra says, Sarva Avatari Krishna Swayam Bhagavan Tahara Dvitiya Deha Sri Balaram. Balaramji is the second most strongest person after Krishna. Krishna is the fountainhead. He is the absolute truth. He is the first person in the universe, in the entire creation, including the material and the spiritual world. And acharyas give example, just like a candle. We can light a second candle from one candle and then third candle from the second candle. Similarly, Krishna is the first. And the next immediate expansion of Krishna is Balaram. From Balaram, the first quadruple, Vasudev Sankarsana Pradyumnan Ruddha, and the second quadruple, Vasudev Sankarsana Pradyumnan Ruddha, and all the avatars, Vishnu avatars, Karnodashaya Vishnu, Kasurodashaya Vishnu, and Mahavishnu, all these avatars, they all come. Rama Dimurtishu Galani Yamena Tishnanana Avatara Makarod Bhuvaneshu Kintu Krishna Swayam Samabhavat Paramapumanyo. All these different incarnations of Krishna, they are all manifestations of Balaram. So, Jivanama Tatastakya Eka Shakti Hai Mahasankarsana Sabha Jivera Ashray. Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami says that Krishna, he is the source of all living entities, but Balaramji is Ashray. He is a shelter of all the living entities, therefore, he carries a plow in his hands. Although our heart is like a barren land where Krishna Prem cannot grow, cannot fructify, but Balaramji with his plow, he plows our heart, the barren land, and somehow tries to sow the seed of Krishna Prem in every living entity's heart. Sahastra Vadaniye Ho Shesha Sankarshan Dasha Deha Dhari Kare Krishna Rasevan. although he is the second most powerful personality in the creation, but his mood is he always wants to serve Krishna. And therefore he expands himself in 10 forms. He expands as Krishna's bed. He expands as Krishna's asana, sitting place. He expands as a chamara, umbrella, Brahman thread, ornaments, Krishna's jewelry, Krishna's dress. And he expands as like all the paraphernalia of Krishna. Therefore, actually Balaramji is a Rohini Nandan. He was born from Mother Rohini. But then what was the need for him to enter the womb of Devaki first, in the heart of Devaki? Because his mood is he always wants to serve Krishna, and therefore, although he took birth, he appeared from Mother Rohini, but he wanted to clean that place first. He wanted to make arrangement for Krishna to appear in the heart of Mother Devaki. Therefore, he was born as a 7th child of Mother Devaki. And of course, and then he was shifted by Yoga Maya from the heart of Devaki to the heart of Mother Rohini.
Teho apana ke kare das bhavana Krishna das bhava vinu ache kona jana.
Now, although he is Supreme Personality Godhead, there is absolutely no difference except the peacock feather. There is absolutely no difference. The color is, Krishna is blackish and Balaramji is whitish. This is the only difference. But there's a gulf of difference in the mood. Balaramji, he wanted to show to the world that I am the most powerful amongst all of you. But my mood is to serve Krishna. Once, when the war was decided, Pandavas and Kauravas, Krishna had already taken the side of Arjun, Pandavas. Shakuni made a plan. Shakuni and Duryodhan went to Dwarka and they started alluring Balaramji. They said, see, Krishna is interested in post position. He wants to become the king. He wants to become the emperor of the entire world. He wants a throne. Balaramji was just listening. And at one point of time, Balaramji became so angry. He said, rascal, shut up. And then he went in his mood of Sankarshan. He said, you stupid fellows, I am the Anantashesha. Thousands hooded Anantashesh. And I am as a bed of sheer Lord Sri Krishna. Forget about the earthly kings. All the gods in the heavenly planet, they somehow they want the dust particle of Krishna's lotus feet. Shiva, Brahma, Lakshmi, I myself, I want the dust of Krishna's lotus feet. Why is he interested in becoming your emperor of Hastinapur? Get lost from here. Shut up. So then Shakuni understood, oh my God, I made a plan, you know, somehow. He was thinking that, you know, Balaramji is also some other king, we can allure him. But then they understood, Balaramji's mood is totally different.
Ekale Ishwara Krishna Ara Sabhavritya Yara Aiche Nachai Seitaiche Karendritya.
Then Balaramji says that Krishna is the supreme puppeteer. And everyone, including all the incarnations, all the avatars, including me, Balaramji, he is also like a puppet in the hands of Krishna. Anantashesh, Krishna, Balaramji performs unlimited role, you know. He has so much of desire to serve Krishna. In one form, is like Anantashesh, he is lying as a bed. And there is Anantashesh separate. He is only glorifying. He is constantly 24 hours doing Bhagavat Katha. Therefore, our Chatushkumar, four Kumar Sampradaya is from Anantashesh. Anantashesh spoke Bhagavatam to four Kumaras, and four Kumaras give Bhagavatam class to others. So he is constantly engaged in glorifying Lord Krishna. So why does Krishna, Balaramji, perform this Leela? He always want to be subservient to Krishna. Once when Krishna performed that Govardhan, lifting Govardhan Leela, so Balaramji thought in his mind, for so many, you know, days and months I have not killed any demon. So today I am in a mood of killing some demon. So he went and approached Krishna. He said, Krishna, can I borrow your peacock feather and a flute for one day? Krishna started laughing. Krishna said, what happened to my brother? He wants a peacock feather and a flute from me? Krishna says, okay. Krishna is not Krishna is not afraid of losing his position, you know. Krishna is the most secured personality. Sometimes we are afraid of losing our post position and, you know, anyone can take away my position. Krishna says, okay, you want to become God? Fine, no problem. So then Krishna gave peacock feather and a flute to, of course, Krishna didn't say that, you want to become God. Krishna says to the living entities. So Balaramji placed the peacock feather on his head and went to the pasturing grounds of Vrindavan Dham, started playing upon the flute. And meanwhile, Kamsa called Keshi demon. He said, hey Keshi, I have sent so many demons. Everyone failed in their mission. I have great hopes from you. Please go and kill that Krishna. Keshi said, my dear sir, don't worry. Rest assured, within 5 minutes I'll kill him and come back. Krishna said, oh, Kamsa said, don't be overconfident. Now I know the past history. Okay, try your best. So Keshi came, and then before going, you know, Keshi asked Kamsa, how does he look like? How will I come to know who is Krishna, whom I have to kill? Krishna was so famous. Kamsa says, don't worry, when you go to Vrindavan, there is only one personality who wears a peacock feather. There is only one personality who wears a peacock feather, and he also plays a flute. So if you go to Vrindavan, there is your one boy who plays flute and he has a peacock feather. Kamsa Kakashi says, that is enough for me. So then he went, and that time Balaramji was wearing a peacock feather with a flute. And Keshi, hey, you are Krishna Kamsa's enemy. And Keshi kicked him with a hand leg on the chest of Balaram. And Balaram fell unconscious. So Keshi thought, Krishna is killed. So Krishna comes, he went back and informed Kamsa. After some time, Balaramji came back to his consciousness, and with reeling his head, crying. Actually, it's Balaramji's Leela. If Balaramji wanted, with one punch, he would have killed and made hundreds and thousands pieces of Keshi demon. But again, Balaramji in such a mood, he performed such a Leelas where Krishna is always glorified by his pastimes. So then crying, he went to Krishna and says, Krishna, please take back your peacock feather. And please take back your flute. I will never ask you again. And then Krishna says, what happened? Why are you crying? And then Balaram narrates the whole incident. Krishna comes in the mood. He says, Sala kon hai re mere bhai ko mara? Then it is mentioned that Krishna flapped his arms and stuck his flute towards the right side and went to the pasturing grounds. And by the time the Keshi also had come to know, although he was not a real Krishna, the Krishna boy is different, and he also came back. So then Krishna killed Keshi demon. So now the interesting part in this, Balaramji showed that wearing a peacock feather, it is so costly for Balaram. Even Balaramji went in trouble when he tried to imitate Krishna wearing a peacock feather. And Kali Yuga Jivas, they are so unfortunate. Everyone wants to become Krishna. No one wants to become Krishna's servant. Actually, why Balaramji always again and again, again and again, he in his pastimes, he wants to show that no one can become God. No one can imitate. Hey, I myself is not different from Krishna, but still there is a difference. I am his servant. And today, you go ask anyone, who is your guru? My guru is incarnation of Krishna. there was one Baba. Nowadays, I think he is in jail. Whenever was a Guru Purnima, his favorite was, he would wear peacock feathers. And he would hold a hose pipe in his hand, water hose pipe. And all his disciples, and especially the lady disciples, they were acting like gopis. And he was Krishna. And on the day of Holi, he would sprinkle water on the gopis. And that Leela went for some years, now in the jail. There was one Baba. He has a long beard. And his disciples called him Unshaven Krishna. And he smiles. Yeah, he nods his head. It's okay. They call me Unshaven Krishna. In Maharashtra, there was one Baba with big petu. Old man, but wearing a peacock feather. It so looks so nasty, you know, old crippled body, but his name is Anantakoti Brahmand Nayak. Anantakoti Brahmand Nayak. So actually Krishna, he loves jokes. Therefore Krishna sometimes in Kali Yuga, he gives full freedom. Try your best. Try your luck to become Krishna. Try to imitate me. I have no problem, absolutely no problem. So, but Brahmaji, Balaramji, with his own Leela he wants to show. And therefore you will find, even sometimes it becomes difficult for Balaramji to understand Krishna fully. During Brahma Mihuman Leela, Brahmaji took away Krishna's boyfriends and the calves and hid them in Brahma planet. This, and Krishna expanded himself as a cowherd boy, friends, and the calves. This Leela went on for 1 year. Balaramji was there. Balaramji could not understand that these boys are not different from Krishna. This is Krishna. But he couldn't fathom it. So then after 1 year, Balaramji says to Krishna, my dear Krishna, tum kaise vyakti ho yaar? Me is not different from you, but still there are so many things which even I don't understand you fully. And then Krishna tells to Balaram, my dear brother, can I tell you something? Balaramji said, yes. Forget about yourself. I myself cannot understand myself. Who am I and what am I? And why my devotees are so much interested in? And therefore, sometimes I become, not sometimes, I myself is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to understand my glories. So, Balaramji, he performs his Leela in such a way that he assists Krishna in his Leela. Bhakta Bhava Angikari Balarama Lakshman Advaita Nityananda Shesha Sankarshan Krishnera Madhurya Rasa Mrita Karepan Sei Sukhe Matta Kichu Nahi Janayan. Amazing! See, when you don't understand anything, you know what is the method? Simplest and safest method is to become humble. When you cannot understand with the pride and arrogance, just become humble. So Krishna and Balaram, they showed by their own example, they become angikara, bhakta bhava angikare. They accept the mood of a devotees. And Balaram and Gauranga, sorry, Krishna becomes Gauranga, Balarams becomes Nityananda. Nityananda Prabhu is Adi Guru. He teaches how to acquire that Krishna Prema, and therefore, or Narottam Das Thakur writes, Nitayare Karuna Hobe Brajaradha Krishna Pave Dharonitai Charana Dukhani. You see, nowadays, this pandemic, COVID, Corona is going on. Everyone is so careful about the contamination. If you touch anything, immediately you sanitize your own hands. If you bring some things from the outside, and immediately we sanitize all the things. We are so careful about little contaminations in this world. And we sanitize ourselves, and we sanitize our things and our hands, everything. Hey, what about the mountain of contamination in the heart? Small contaminations, every time wash your hands with the sanitizer. And what about the mountains of this contamination in the heart? In Kali Yuga, therefore, there is no process, absolutely no yajna, no mantra, no nothing is working. Absolutely, of course, there are hundreds and thousands of processes, but Nityananda Prabhu, Dharanitai Charana Dukhani. And the amazing part is, you catch hold the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu, grab the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu, and what will happen? What is the next line? Se sambandho nahi jar Britha janma gelo tar Sei pashu bado durachar Sei pashu bado Durachar. Narottam Das Thakur says, if you have no connection with Nityananda Prabhu, you britha janma gelo, your life is wasted. Sei pashu bado durachar. You are a pashu. You are like an animal. Out of compassion, Narottam Das Thakur is not, condemning anyone. Out of love, out of compassion, he is calling everyone, those who don't take shelter of Nityananda Prabhu's lotus feet, he is calling that you are an animal. Because when you catch hold of the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu, the same bhava, the love of the gopis, is offered to you effortlessly. Big gods and sages and rishis, for performing tapasya and austerities and vratas and tapas for millions of years, still it remains unlimitedly away from them. And here, the simple, safest, easiest method is just grab the lotus feet of Lord Nityananda Prabhu. Careful. This is Acharya. Prabhupada, he knew the secret. Prabhupada knew there were two things in Prabhupada's heart. First of all, unlimited compassion for all the living entities. And most secret he knew that Nityananda Prabhu is unlimitedly merciful. This is for Kali Yuga. Nityananda Prabhu is for Kali Yuga. And therefore, just imagine, there were some countries in the Western world, they had no idea, no concept of God. Forget who is God, no idea about God. And here, Prabhupada is directly introducing them Gaurnitai deities. Worship them. Parama Karuna Pahuduijar Nitai Gaurachandra. There are hundreds and thousands of professional Bhagavad Kathakars. Hours and hours and hours and hours give kathas to people. And even in their kathas, people who were not, thousands of people attend the kathas. And then when they speak the kathas, leelas of Radha and Krishna Vrindavan, they cry tears. And after the katha, everything, you know, back to normal. How many people have given up the four regulative principles? So how many people are starting following the four regulative principles? How many people have given up meditating and drinking liquor? How many people after hearing these kathas? Because that acharya, who is in the line of that compassion, only he knows the secret. And therefore he knows in Kali Yuga, only Balaram, who appeared as Nityananda Prabhu. So Prabhupada said, don't worry. You start chanting Hare Krishna mantra and you have a backup support of Nityananda Prabhu's mercy. Go ahead. And then Narottam Das Thakur, Nitaina bolilo mukhe majile magile samsaro sukhe vidyakule ki koribeta. This human form of life is meant only to serve Nityananda Prabhu. Nityananda Prabhu's lotus feet and chant his holy name. Once Prabhupada, in 1972, early 1972, he was in Vrindavan with his Western devotees. And he was just walking in the Ramanreti area. And he had just acquired the land, some two acres land as a donation. And Prabhupada looked at the direction of that land. And Prabhupada said, here in this land, we'll have Krishna and Balaram as a presiding deity. And then Prabhupada said, there are two reasons. The first reason is, in Vrindavan, overall, everywhere, there is Radha Krishna deities, and as a main altar, presiding deities. But here, we'll have Krishna Balaram. It's a very unique and special, something different. And see, today, Prabhupada, because he's directly in touch with Krishna, so he knows. So today Krishna Balaram temple is the most famous. And then Prabhupada said, because this is Raman Reti, this is a playground of Krishna and Balaram. And how the Krishna is looking and how he is standing and Balaram is standing. Prabhupada looked in the Bhaktivedanta magazine and he saw the picture. Wow. Krishna, Balaram is resting on the shoulder of Krishna. Prabhupada said, our deity should be like this. And now you see, devotees from all over the world, they have the shelter. When you go to Krishna Balaram temple, beautiful, gorgeous, royal Balaramji is standing and Krishna is there. Don't worry, be fearless, come to me. Take shelter of my lotus feet and you will be happy. So today is Balaramji's birthday, appearance day of Balaramji. How he appeared in this world? Rohini Mata, she was one of the wife of Vasudeva. She was 3 months pregnant when Vasudeva sent her to Nanda Maharaj's place in Gokul because he was in the jail. So Rohini Mata, she arrived in Vrindavan riding on a horse in the night time because she didn't want to take a risk. So she came in the night at Nanda Maharaj's bhavan. Everyone was so joyous, so happy. And immediately, Yashoda Mai and Rohini Mata, they became a thick friend. So she was already 3 months pregnant. So when it became 14 months pregnancy, Lord Balaramji, of course from Devaki's heart to Rohini Mata's heart, he was shifted. And then on this most auspicious day, a full moon day of Shravan month, Balaramji appeared. He was so beautiful. All the gods in the heavenly planets started showering flowers on the beautiful divine body of Balaramji. And they all shouted and glorified, Jai, Jai, Jai Balaram, Jai, Jai. So in this way, Balaramji appeared. But although he was so beautiful, white his body and lotus petal-like eyes, exactly like Krishna, but he was inactive, like Sri Radha. Like Sri Radha also, she did not see unless Krishna came and touched her. She would not see, she would not hear, she would not even do anything. Similarly, Balaramji also, Jiva Goswami writes, Balaramji also, he was not seeing anything, he was not speaking to anyone. But once Yashoda Mai took baby Balaram and embraced that Balaram to her heart, and suddenly Balaramji opened his eyes and he started laughing. Everyone became shocked. How did it happen? Because Yashoda Mai was carrying Krishna in the heart. Because she was also pregnant. So she was carrying Krishna in her heart. So Balaramji got touched with Krishna in the heart of Yashoda Mai, and immediately he became fully active. And as soon as Mother Yashoda put him down, brought away from her, again Balaramji became achetan, inactive. And as soon as Mother Yashoda would held, Mother Yashoda would held him to her heart, he would again become completely active. So Balaramji serves Krishna in many capacities, but especially in five rasas. Balaramji serves Krishna in the dasya mode by expanding himself as a paraphernalia of Krishna. He also serves mainly in sakya rasa as a friend, a very intimate friend of Krishna. And he also serves Krishna in vatsalya mood. What is his vatsalya? How he serves Krishna as vatsalya? Because Balaramji always acts as a protector of Krishna. Therefore, you will find whenever Krishna would go for, every day Krishna would go to for pasturing ground for herding the cows, grazing the cows, and Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mai, every day they would go to Balaram. I said, Balaram, you are elder brother, you are very strong, please protect Krishna. Is Vrindavan is such an amazing place. Everyone in Braj, they know that only Krishna protects them. Whenever there is a trouble, whenever there are some problems in their life, they see that Krishna is protecting them. But immediately, the next moment, that love and affection pours from their heart to heart so spontaneously, they feel like, Krishna is just an innocent child and he needs our protection. This is Krishna's special arrangement. Krishna, he doesn't want to be a great personality. He doesn't act like a god in Vrindavan. He is the youngest member of Braj. He is the youngest member of his family. He is the youngest member of the Braj. So that all the Brajavasis, they will shower their love and affection on Krishna. Therefore, you will find in the Vaikuntha planet, in other rasas, the devotees cannot shower their blessings and affection and love to Vishnu. Of course, there is no need also. But here, Krishna acts in such a way, those Brajavasis spontaneously they give a love and affection to Krishna. When Krishna entered in a Kaliya lake and he was in the coils of Kaliya, the news reached to all the Brajavasis. Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Mai became more worried because that day Balaramji was not with Krishna. So then they come to know, Balaramji also is not with him. Then they became so afraid and then they started running towards the Kaliya Daha, that Kaliya lake. This shows that Balaramji, he acts or he serves Krishna in a vatsalya mood. And because most of the time he acted as like a elder brother of Krishna, therefore many times there would be some circumstances, some leelas of Krishna and Radharani where Balramji would be all the time present, but Balramji would never make his brother embarrassed. Suppose like, you know, when Balramji would see from the distance, Krishna is with Sri Radha, because Govardhan Silas, when Sri Radha would walk to go to Krishna, to meet Krishna on Govardhan Hill, so her lotus golden footprints were there on a Govardhan Sila. And Balramji would look at the golden footprints next to Krishna's bluish footprints. And then Balramji would understand, oh, my brother is with Sri Radha. So he didn't want to embarrass him. So he would take a different path and go to some different place. This is Balramji's mood. And Balramji came to know that my brother Krishna, he plays very sweet flute, no? And he attracts and enchants everyone's heart and is very expert in Rasa Leela. Balramji, he also had a desire to see Rasa Leela. But if he enters into Rasa Leela, the whole mood is off. Krishna will become embarrassed. Oh, my dear brother, what are you doing here? Of course, Balramji also is present in the Rasa Leela in the form of Ananga Manjari, because Krishna, Balramji serves Krishna in all the rasas. He also serves in the Madhurya Rasa. He is subservient to Krishna. He becomes Ananga Manjari and participates in Rasa Leela. But whenever, as Balram, he wants to see Rasa Leela, he just lies down on the top of the mountain Govardhan, and from distance he sees towards the Chandra Sarovar that Krishna is performing beautiful Rasa Leela with the gopis. And from the corner, look, from the corner he is looking at Krishna's Rasa Leela. Therefore he is called Look Dauji or Doka Dauji, and went in ecstasy, oh my brother's Rasa Leela is so beautiful. So he serves Krishna in all the rasas. So when Balramji appeared, so he was inactive. Finally, Krishna also appeared after 8 days. Balramji is only 8 days older than Krishna. Is it true? Yes, because Jiva Goswami says their name-giving ceremony was happened in the same day. If he was 1 year older, then naturally they would have performed name-giving ceremony before. Isn't it? But now, in Goshala, Gargamuni, Gargacharya, he performed a name-giving ceremony together, Balramji and Krishna. So that shows he is only 8 days elder to Krishna. So when Krishna and Balram, when Krishna also appeared, Balram became very happy. Now both of them, they started performing leelas together. They would sometime catch hold the tail of a calf, and the calf, they would become afraid, they would start running, and they would drag Krishna and Balram through the cow muds, the cow dung and the cow urine, and their whole body would be smeared upon with the cow dung and the cow urine. I heard it. I don't know the exact authenticity. Therefore, Krishna is called Ghasitaram. Ghasitaram means one who is dragged by the calf through this cow dung and the cow urine. So all these beautiful pastimes Krishna and Balram, they perform. Sometimes Krishna and Balram, just small kids, you know, 1 year old, but they would challenge the big giants, bulls. They had huge horns. Krishna and Balram would catch the big horns and they would wrestle with the bulls. And Mother Rohini and Yashoda, they sometimes fear and also sometimes enjoy these beautiful pastimes of and Krishna and Balaram. Of course, the time is running fast, so we'll cut down our stories, pastimes. I also narrate one beautiful pastime of Romaharshana. When Balaramji came to know about Mahabharata's war,
that now this war is inevitable. So Balramji said, okay, I am not interested in taking part of any side. Therefore, he went on a pilgrimage. And finally, he came to Naimisharanya, where thousands of sages, they were performing yajna of Shravanam, hearing beautiful lilas. So they had selected Roma Harshan as their vakta, their speaker, kathakar. So when Balramji entered in that assembly, everyone, out of respect, they stood up and gave respect to Balramji. But Roma Harshan kept sitting. He did not get up from his seat. And Balramji, with a transcendental mercy, he thought this fellow is very proud, arrogant. So Balramji said, okay, let me give my mercy to him. He just took one straw, a blade of grass, and touched his forehead. And Roma Harshan was delivered. All the sages started crying. Just now, 5 minutes before, we had given him up. We had given him benediction of long life. let you remain and live for long life so that you will speak katha. And you finished up all our benediction within 5 minutes. He is killed. So Balramji said, oh, you are feeling guilty that you gave benediction and then it's not in work. If you want, I can bring him back to life. But then the rishis and sages said, no, no problem, because it is your desire, so be it. But please give his benedictions, the same benedictions to his son, Suta Goswamiji. So then Suta Goswami was made as a speaker, as a kathakar. So Balramji, he wanted to show that even though we may be a big, big scholars and the pandits and whoever, Balramji said, I myself, is subservient to Krishna, I'm always, I carry that mood of being the servant. So we should also, a devotee, also should develop that same mood. So therefore, on this most auspicious occasion, so there are many prayers, but especially these two verses are mentioned and recommended. Namaste halagraha, namaste musalayudha, namaste revati kanta, namaste bhaktavasala, namaste balarama sreshta, namaste dharani dhara, pralambare namaste stu, trahimam krishna purvaja. Obeisances to you, O dear Balaram, one who holds the plow and the mess in his hands. You are very, very dear to Mother Revati, and you are very affectionate towards your devotees. Please give me your protection. And there is one beautiful pastime of Balramji. I'll just narrate in a few minutes. How Balramji was married to Revati. So in Satyuga, there was one king. His name was Revata. And he had a beautiful daughter. Divine qualities. He was born so divine personality. And then Revata could not see any person matching as a husband to her, because she was such a beautiful and unlimitedly divine personality. Who could be matched to her? So finally Revata, along with his daughter, went to Brahma's planet and started discussing with Brahmaji, who is the best match, you know, for my daughter. Balramji, Brahmaji said, you made a mistake. You came to Satyaloka and you had just few moments with the discussion with me. And if you find, Satyuga is already lost. On earth planet, Satyuga is gone. Treta Yuga also is left. And it is the end of the Dwapar Yuga. But anyway, don't worry. Now, Balramji is there, who is the eternal, actually Revati is the eternal consort of Balramji. So now you go and get your daughter married to Balramji. So Revata, along with his daughter, came on this earth planet. And Revata, King Revata, he requested Balramji,
please get married to my daughter. Balaramji said, where is your daughter? He said, here is my daughter. Balaramji looked like this. She was tall like in the sky. Balaramji said, is your daughter? Ravana said, yes, we were born in Satya Yuga. Balaram said, don't worry, this is my Leela. He took his plow and dragged her down, pulled her down of his matching to his size. and Revati, she was very happy, and Balaramji was very happy, and they got happily married. But Balaramji, he had one remorse in his heart. He was unhappy. You know why? Because Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, Nishedha karite nare yate chota bhai mona dhari rahe lakshman mane dukha pai. Because in a previous Leela, in Treta Yuga, Lakshman was a younger brother. He was always just following the instruction of Ram. Sometimes he wouldn't like the instructions. Like, you know, Lord Ram tells Lakshman, Sita is banished, take her to the forest. It's like, you know, mountain falling on the heart of Lakshman. Every time Ram gives such a, you know, instructions. So then at the end of Lakshman's Leela, Lakshman decided, now henceforward I'll never become a younger brother. So therefore in Dwapar Yuga, before, you know, Krishna and Balaram appeared, Balaramji went and spoke very intimately with Krishna. My dear brother, I'm extremely sorry, but this time I'll appear as your elder brother, okay? Krishna started laughing. He said, okay. So today is that most auspicious day where Balaramji appeared to shower his unlimited blessings upon all the conditioned souls in this world. Jai Balaram Mahashay ki jai, Balaram Jayanti Mahamahotsav ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Krishna Balaram ki jai. Thank you very much.